that all this attention is hardly for Michael Murray alone. Last throw of the dice, and it must be thrown properly. Can't say I agree wholeheartedly. Can't say I agree at all. Didn't do stunts like this when I first joined. Not to our fellow countrymen. Well, not often. Told it was very isolated. Minimum risk. Touch of the adrenaline, nevertheless, seeing the troops in the field. Brutal times. Well, I'll see you soon. Safe and well. Your father sends his regards, Baba.
All those liberal doubts.
I know. And he'd blow torch his grandchildren for a peerage. How is Murray? Really?
Foul, stupid, ignorant, hysterically funny, and strangely wonderful in bed. I haven't had such a good time since... Well...
Distracting him for a few more days shouldn't be too much of a hardship then. Should it?
If number 10 Downing Street changes hands in the very near future?
We destroy a few files, and then we carry on as normal. It won't make any difference.
Certainly helps to be cynical.
Why not? After all, that great socialist in Iron Bevan was followed around by MI5 for years, on the express orders of Clem Attlee, the Labour Prime Minister at the time.
I already knew that.
Very good. And did you also know that the same Labour government had Michael Murray's father investigated before his untimely death?
Was he an idiot and a rogue as well?
No, he wasn't. He was an active and powerful man in the trades union movement, almost famous in his day. But something didn't rub off on his son, because Michael Murray Sr. was an intensely decent and honourable man. MI5 didn't know what to make of him at all.
I know the feeling. When did you order that taxi?
About 7 hours ago.
Barbara! Barbara, where have you been?
I'm sorry, Michael. But as soon as you'd left, some colleagues of mine in Derbyshire rang up and I just had to go. I've actually discovered the site of the first example of Druid cave poetry in iambic pentameters and rhyming couplets.
Are you taking the piss out of me or what?
Yeah.
And it's barman's, that's right. No, really. A pint, and a woman for the night, £1. And this bloke says, nah, there's something wrong with it. Whose pies are they? There's more to me than telling jokes, I think.
Of course
course there is. But normally I don't hear any jokes. I just see them and suffer them.
Well, doctor, I can't feel my legs. That's because I've amputated your arms.
That's awful.
Yeah, but it's armless.
Oh.
Don't bother talking to me unless you like wasting words.
Your brother in...
My brother, your police.
Are you going to give me that, Ravi?
My solicitor.
Well, whatever you think best.
He's got a broken nose, broken legs, and internal injuries they can only guess at.
It isn't us.
His dentist wouldn't even know him.
It isn't us.
Flap your wings when you say that.
What?
Pigs were seen flying or lying.
Look, be upset, but behave. Now, I know it isn't us. I've even been told who it is, but you wouldn't believe me.
Who is it, then? The National Front?
I wish it was. No, it's like the highway code. Look left, look right, look left again.
The left? You take a leave of your senses.
Look, I know it's the left. I know it is. One of them come into the bridewell, sick of himself, spilt everything.
Blood, no doubt, in your bridewell.
As I am standing here, Ravi, I know the bloke who took the statement.
Rumours. Doesn't add up.
It does to me. Government comes to power. Government of law and order, right? What happens? Law and order falls apart, riots break out, anarchy the next step. Revolution a step nearer.
No, come on. This is the 1990s. There are no revolutions left. There are no communists left. Someone's been filling you full of wind, Mr. Kennedy. And you just farted.
You see.
My key, please.
Do me a favour.
The Durex machine's full. I've already checked.
No, listen.
And you've had a visit.
Did she come here?
Yeah.
Eileen Critchley came here?
No, your wife. I must say, she's a very attractive woman, Maureen, you know, even when she's upset.
What does she want? She didn't want anything. She just brought you clothes. It was a bit unpleasant because she left them in the foyer at a particularly busy time and made a sort of announcement of the fact.
How could she do this to me? Two wrongs don't make a right. She should know that.
Is there anything else, Michael? I have this slight crisis with the drains and...
Yeah. You know what a great young waiter you sent up with a champagne last night? That nice kid. Do us a favour, Jeff. Get him to bring up some more, would you? Jeff, can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you. There's no need to shout. I'd have to shout for him to hear me. He's in intensive care. He got beaten senseless leaving here last night.
He didn't deserve that.
Few people do.
I could name some. I can't begin to tell you the favour he did me last night.
He did you two favours. He was the one who got your wife out of the hotel. No one else could.
Oh, God, I'm so sorry.
Why don't I get the champagne taken up to your room?
In a while.
It's not for me to say, Michael. I know he helped you out. But there's no need for you to take it that badly.
Yes, there is. Was he robbed as well, the lad?
Yeah. What were you doing tipping him 60 quid? You'll spoil him.
He was worth the spoiling. Do us a favour. Make sure he gets that. I am... very sorry. Michael Murray. And then put an armed guard around his bed.